Hello guys and welcome back to my channel, or if you're new here, my name is Miranda. Today I'm going to be showing you guys how I did this very simple pink to red shift type look. You can do it with, without liner. I always do liner and lashes as per usual, but really up to you guys. I think this is perfect for Valentine's Day. I'm not really sure what I'm going to do myself for Valentine's Day yet, but hopefully this can give you guys some ideas, maybe some inspiration. It's very much up my alley as far as my aesthetic goes for my looks. But yeah, it's one of my favorite looks that I've been doing recently, especially around the Valentine's Day season. But yeah, if you want to see how I did this look, then just keep on watching. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to be doing is using my NARS blush in the shade Exhibit A. It is a very, very bright neon red, and I'm going to be applying this on the outer corner, basically, of my eye. And I'm using the ColourPop F12 brush. It's a very compact, slightly angled brush, but it's very large, which is really good for packing on this color. I am packing it on, not swiping. I'm just going to very gently start to press that onto the eye. This is the, what is it? It doesn't have, well, there's no writing on this, so I'm not sure. It must have rubbed off, I guess, but I'm just using a blending brush and really not blending the actual lid space. I'm just blending very gently the outer edges to kind of feather that color out and create more of a gradient and not have harsh lines. But you will have to go in with different layers. But I am going to be going in the same brush, but I have a new palette and I really want to try out some of the colors. I recently ordered the Melt Cosmetics. I don't even know how to say the name of this. I don't want to even try to pronounce this, but it's so beautiful. I love this palette so much. I'm definitely gonna try and use, not today, but I definitely wanna mess with this dark blue. It's so pretty. I hate using cool tones, but I really wanna try it out. I'm gonna be going into Corazon, this really, really bright red. This is my first time trying this palette, but Melt Cosmetics shadows blend like an absolute dream. Again, just stamping my brush in. There's really not that much fallout. So that's a lot darker than the NARS color, which is what I initially put down. There's really not much fallout, but again, that's why I am stamping. Personally, I'm not that mad if red fallout gets on my face, just because I can just blend it away. And I'm really just bringing this color into like the middle of my lid, because I will be doing a different inner corner color. We're gonna be going in with like a hot shimmery pink. This color is so beautiful. I love working with reds. And then using my spare Morphe M441. This isn't my main one that I use like every day for my neutral colors. This is specifically designed for random blending that I do on occasion. But very gently. When you're blending, you want to hold your brush at the very end, just because that helps to have more control over the pressure that you're putting on, rather than putting, like, holding very close. But this just allows me to have a very, very light hand and really focus on those outer edges to create a nice seamless blend. With reds, I really recommend just taking your time. They're some of my favorite colors to work with, reds and pinks, but similar to very dark or black eyeshadows, they can go wrong very, very quickly. Not as bad as if you use a black and mess up with that. That's very hard to correct, but kind of similar to if you're using a red lipstick and you mess up, you try to cover it up, it turns pink and it smears and it just spreads everywhere. And basically that's red. It's really hard to get rid of and really hard to cover up. And then I'm going to very gently blend in the middle, the center of the lid, just to prepare for applying the pink. So I'm going to be next using the ColourPop E4, and it already has hot pink on it. This is the only brush that I use for this specific shade. But first I need to apply, I'm going to apply some primer. I don't ever use eyeshadow primer. I don't think it actually does anything, but in this case specifically, this eyeshadow that I'm going to use has fallout, and throughout the day it like falls off my eye, and I don't really know why. Maybe I put too much on, but it shouldn't do that. So I'm gonna be using the Urban Decay Primer Potion, and this just kind of adds some stick. It'll have like some tackiness to it. I probably should have primed my whole eye, but I'm really just needing it for this shadow specifically. But I'm going to be going in with the infamous Shane Dawson and Jeffree Star Conspiracy Palette. I bought this because I like Shane Dawson. I've watched all of his series. But I'm going to be going in with the shade Trisha. It's one of my favorite shades in the palette. It's absolutely beautiful, but when I apply it, it like, it has fallout, and like throughout the day it falls like on my face, and it's super hard to get off your face. Like once it falls down and you like try and like blend it away, it doesn't. It doesn't do that. It's a very difficult shade I've found to work with. And I've worked with plenty of pinks in my life, but I'm really gonna tap off as much excess as I physically can. And then I am just very gently packing this on. If you guys watch Nikki tutorials, she always says, I mean, what she always does also is she packs on, like stamp, she calls it stamping, I'm pretty sure. But you stamp on the color and you blend after. Which is not wrong with them. I just love the pink to red shift. I'm not sure if you guys can actually see right now on camera, but I'm gonna be going back in with my original brush that I'm not picking up any more color, and I'm just going to very gently stamp over the pink just to merge the two colors together and make them look pretty seamless, a nice gradient flow from one color to the other. Hello? Oh my god! This is like a fucking bug focusing this stupid lens. I'm going in with my Real Techniques Point Extra 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 Small brush. I'm going to be going back into my NARS blush, again in the shade Exhibit A, and just packing that on and starting at the outer corner, or outer lower lash line, I guess. And very gently bringing that color to the inner corner. Most of the color, like, you're depositing most of the color on the outer corner, and then bringing in any excess to the inner, just because having the inner corner be too dark or too intense. On me personally, just the way that I look, it doesn't look great. Alrighty, so you guys can either leave this look how it is and just do mascara and lashes. I'm gonna do liner, as I usually do for my looks. I'll probably end up doing a video all about how I do my liner, but for now, not as that day is not today that I'm doing that. But I'm just gonna go in with the Urban Decay Perversion brush tip liner and do that. She's not even, but with lashes you won't be able to tell. It's not my best liner, it's not my favorite liner, so I think what I'm gonna do is add a little baby wing underneath my big wing, Sometimes I'll do this just to add a little bit more dimension to a look. Once I have lashes on, you really can't tell like face forward, but when you turn to the side, you are able to see that little line. So just using whatever liner you want, really, I'm just going to extend another line out and then connect. I'm not sure if you guys can see, but just add a little bit more something. It reminds me more of like a rocker type look. I don't know. I'm gonna be using the ColourPop X Halo Top, the ice cream collection. I wish they would bring this back. ColourPop, bring this back. This is in the shade Sherbet Day. It's such a pretty color. I think that looks focused. I'm using a different lens today, so I'm hoping, but it's so pretty and it's like a hot pink, but it's glittery and it's got like some dimension to it. So I'm just gonna pop this on my inner corner and then I'm gonna go over top of it with a brighter, like lighter shade, but it'll still have that pink hue. Okay, then mascara, I'm going to be using the Milk Makeup Kush Mascara, and then lashes, I'm going to be putting on my Bold Face Makeup Alter Ego lashes as per usual. I'm going to be coating my top and bottom lashes, so when that is all done, I will show you the final look. Okay, then this is the final look. I hope you guys like it. Let me know if you have any questions. My parents just got home. And of course, they're not gonna stop barking until my parents come back inside. I'm sorry that this outro is loud. I'm sorry that my dogs don't shut up. But I hope you guys like this look. I love you guys so, so much, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye! Thank you.